The popcorn tastes like styrofoam too. Huh? Y'all just not trying no more. Cause there's no way the popcorn should taste like styrofoam.
The fuck are you talking about? That shit stinks.
Yo, welcome back to another episode of One Star Bruh. This week we are gonna be reviewing the movie theater brand Regal. I personally like Regal theaters. It depends on which one I go to. Some Regal theaters are like very nice, and then some Regal theaters you shouldn't go to. If you like the video, make sure you like, comment, subscribe, all the good stuff on YouTube. And if you're on Instagram, make sure you follow the page at One Star Bruh. Disclaimer, if I find something extremely funny in this video, or I don't understand something at all, I'm gonna play this Will I Am clip.
Apple has more money than American government has liquid.
I don't know what the fuck that means, but it's hilarious, and I just wanna use it somehow in this video. So without further ado, let's get into these reviews, bit out. Once inside a theater, two people ran in and started screaming and punching the wall. Never again. Did they just escape from an asylum? Why were people running and punching the wall? There were bugs in the popcorn. Huh? There were bugs in the popcorn.
That nigga's tripping.
Well, not refund, only exchange. Gross. So, sir, we don't do that. What we can do is give you new popcorn, which probably has bugs in it too, but that's all I can do. What you mean you don't want it? It gives it some extra crunch. Rats crawling everywhere. Went to customer service to complain and get refunded and not even make a big deal out of it. I mean, the rats want to see a movie too. Maybe Ninja Turtles was playing and they was like, hey yo, Master Splinter, that's my nigga B. He changed up once he got in these movies though. Shh, used to be cool. On second thought, man, fuck Master Splinter. Saw three different rats run across the screen while the movie was playing. And I wasn't the only one who noticed. Yelp must not have approved of my review. I said this is a horrible theater with a general manager who assaulted me in an empty auditorium for sexting during one of the year's worst films. I'm in contact with their home office regarding this matter. Huh? So you were sexting in the movie theater and the manager came and told you pretty much probably, hey, sir, don't sex in the theater. Now, if you were just sending a dirty text message, okay, that's a little bit of invasion of privacy. I get it. But if you had your dick and balls out, I mean, you should be stopped. I would have stopped you myself. Yes. Matter of fact, Will I Am can explain it better than I can.
Apple has more money than American government has liquid.
Perfect. What is this shit? I just don't understand how greedy the theaters are. You're already charging me $60 for a bucket of popcorn, $40 for a cup of drink, and now you're gonna skimp me on the toilet paper. You could afford 2-ply toilet paper. Who would like Dolphin Mall Theater? People who don't mind cell phones ringing throughout the entire movie, teenagers texting, adults translating the movies to their companion, people making loud comments in Spanish, people who don't understand the concept that once the previews are done, it's time to shut the fuck up. People making loud comments in Spanish off top makes this a great review. El Gato! Last film I saw there was Action, and a gentleman next to me found it necessary to scream out, yeah, kill that motherfucking white boy every 5 minutes and in front of his 6-year-old daughter. Also, I noticed a lot of young single men loitering by the exits, sipping jumbo-sized theater sodas, hollering at girls walking by. Yes, sir. Hey, little mama, let me talk to you. What's up? What's up? I see you got a jumbo hot dog. Do you want me to give you a jumbo hot dog? I want you to pop my corn. The lady I spoke with, who should be fired with the way she treated me, she called my friend fat after an altercation happened, and we were completely shocked. The manager, Patrick, stood there and didn't do anything. Patrick was probably standing there like, yeah, she is kind of fat. Oh, I said that out loud. My TV is this big. Also, I ordered boneless chicken, read the label. It said it was at 3:30 p.m. I came to the movies at 7:45. Sir, you didn't say you wanted fresh chicken tenders. You just said chicken tenders. My boyfriend and I went to see Wonder Woman and noticed a rat running on the floor. You would think that in a dark theater, you wouldn't see the rat until we saw the rat climbing up the wall like Spider-Man. We immediately left because I was so disgusted and demanded to speak to the manager and get a refund. When we spoke to management, some of the employees commented and said, oh, you guys seen Mickey Mouse, huh? And I was like, what the fuck, you guys name vermin? Terrence Howard the man, you back. You Terrence, we gotta do that film and a tape this time. I will ASAP, by tomorrow.
Apple has more money than American government has liquid.
Thanks, Wyatt. I took my grandson to see Harriet, the movie about a runaway black slave woman. The movie was based on a true story. Excellent movie. My grandson and I could not believe that IMAX Theater put the showing of Harriet in the very back of the theater, the very last door of the hallway. It made me feel like IMAX was making a statement. I feel like the movie could have been placed midway. It's sad to see the mental games being played by making this type of statement. Joyce, get your fake woke bullshit out of here. First of all, before this movie, you didn't even know who Harriet Tubman was. You clearly explained that it was based on a true story, meaning you didn't even fucking know she was a real person. Oh, this is real? Damn, this is great. She's amazing. Second of all, you didn't say, damn, they should have put this movie in the front where it belongs. You said, eh, they could put this movie midway. They shouldn't be in the front with all the other prominent white movies. This one needs to be midway. Not at the front, though. Get the fuck out of here, Joyce. I reported a nasty bathroom incident. I had almost stepped in, maybe a pea size, but still gross. Instead of the manager apologizing to me, he told me he had seen worse and said, oh, so what you want me to clean your shoe? Then looked the other way and totally ignored me. It's not my fault you stepped in shit. Next time, how about you use them big ass eyes and look where you stepping in? Now get the fuck out of my theater. I saw a man shaving in the bathroom here. Huh? I have an interview soon. That's why I'm shaving here. I'm not homeless. You got change? They don't soundproof their theaters. Fair outside super loud. Ruin a movie experience and laugh when I ask if they could do anything about it. I would have laughed too. You want me, the nigga that could barely pop popcorn, to go soundproof a theater? Hey, yo, Will out here.
Apple has more money than American government has liquid.
Zero salt options available. I even asked the guy at the concession counter for some on the side to take into the theater with me. And he said if anyone saw him giving me salt, he'd get fired. It gotta be a salt guy like at the back of the theater. Hey, yo, what you need? You need some salt? Yeah, I got you, homie. That'd be $2. Nigga, you want the salt or not? The loaded fries were dry, cold, cheese sauce was tasteless, and the bacon passed its prime. The hot dog was already made and was tossed onto the counter where it made a loud thud. The bun was so hard and crispy, it was like a cracker. The popcorn tasted stale and the butter smelled rancid. The bathroom was the worst. No wonder it smells. Saw a man pissing on the floor. I would have been in the bathroom like, sir, you know there are toilets in here, right? Hey, hold on. Watch out with the piss, R. Kelly. Hold on. That was the Regal Movie Theater Reviews, man. It's classic. This is a top 10 review for me. If you enjoyed the video, man, make sure you like, comment, subscribe, all of that great stuff. And again, if you are on Instagram, make sure you follow the page at One Star Bruh. And as always, my friends, we out you.
The fuck are you talking about? That shit stinks.
Apple has more money than American government has liquid.